12 News' Mike Gousha watched the president's speech this afternoon as well.
And Mike joins us here. And Mike, some of the big questions today, why Wisconsin, why Racine?
Well, let's start with the question, why Wisconsin? And this is just a case of political realities. In the last presidential election, Wisconsin was a very blue state. It was a very Democratic state. The president won here easily. Times have changed in Wisconsin, and the president and the folks in Washington are well aware of the fact that in the latest political polls, Democrats have their hands full. Russ Feingold barely leading either of his potential challengers in the U.S. Senate race. In the Democratic governor's race, Tom Barrett is the almost certain candidate, but in the poll that was just released today, the public policy polling group found him trailing either of his potential Republican opponents. So it's a political reality situation for the president. That's part of the reason he's here. Why Racine? Very simple. It's between Milwaukee and Chicago, and it means more media coverage for a message that, frankly, Democratic officials will tell you they need to sharpen their jobs message. Some of what you heard from those folks outside today talk about jobs, and they need to do a better job of that. They would concede that.
So there's strategy, there's tone. It was of note today, the president taking a few shots at the Republican Party.
Absolutely. I think all of us who watched the speech today thought it sounded very much like a campaign speech, like he was running for president. There were not so veiled comments about the House Minority Leader John Boehner. There were shots at the Republican Party for their position on Wall Street reform, or whether BP should put $20 billion of its own money to pay for costs associated with the oil disaster in the Gulf. So yeah, it had that tone. It had kind of an edge to it, and it was interesting to hear at this stage as the president, who's talked about being a uniter, really went after the opposing party today.
And Mike, you also talked to Republican Representative Paul Ryan, who represents Racine in Congress.
Absolutely does. And Congressman Ryan, in a satellite interview, had some fairly tough words for the president. He said he was shocked at the tone of today's remarks, and we'll have much more on that tonight at 6 o'clock.
We'll look forward to it. Thanks, Mike. Mm-hmm.
President Obama made a surprise detour on the way to his town hall meeting today. President stopped at O&H Bakery to buy some Kringle. The president shook hands with dozens of customers inside the store.
Right, and he sampled a pecan Kringle, which he called outstanding. President Obama ordered one pecan, one cherry, and one cheese Kringle. He insisted on paying full price for the treats, $7.45 apiece. A 12 News viewer caught this video of President Obama's motorcade traveling through Racine this afternoon. Viewer Jennifer Cook says she was driving home when traffic stopped for about 20 minutes to let the motorcade through. If you see news happening, you can upload your video and pictures onto the U Local section of WISN.com. And you can see the president's speech in its entirety on our website, WISN.com. We also want to hear what you think of those comments that he made, and you can leave yours as well. And take a look at our slideshow of images from today's presidential visit. Just go to the homepage of WISN.com.